So you're probably triggered by the title and the thumbnail, right? Well, you should be. Let me explain. Gabriel, cue the intro. What's going on, Super Saiyans? Welcome back to another Teach Me Tuesday. That's what's up. Real quick though, if you do like this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up and share it with someone. Share it with whoever. Share it with your nan. So for many of you that have followed me for a while, you know that I come from a sports and fitness background, from playing basketball in school, football in school, rugby, to then basketball at uni, to then American football. It has encompassed my whole kind of life. And then more recently, where you've seen like the progress and stuff is like my time on the bodybuilding stage, well, physique, sorry, and then boxing now. But recently, I've been hearing a lot of nonsense, a lot of negativity around certain things, especially in the bodybuilding world. So let's just name a couple. So number one would be shaming newbies. So there's two types of newbies though. So there's the newbies which are like arrogant. You know, they come in the gym, they're new to the gym, but they feel like they know everything. So like, even when you try to assist, not like teach people how to suck eggs, because you know, people have pride as well, but being approached and he's like, do you want a little bit of help or whatever? And they're just like, no, and then they're doing everything wrong. Then it's very hard to save them. They're already set in their ways kind of thing. But then you've got the second type of newbie that when you ask a question, oh, what are you looking to work? Oh, that's probably not the best machine for you. Why don't you try this? They're the ones that are willing to learn. So shaming those people who actually want to make a difference to their body, like say they're like massively overweight, and I've seen it in some of my old gyms, and you see people laughing and stuff like that, which kind of leads on to point number two, which is just criticizing people who aren't looking like you.
Think you have amazing skill, just need to lose some weight. Where is the last time you saw your abs? You're so fatter this moment. Winter is nice, haha. Drumev is getting a little bit fat, but still Drumev power.
So let me explain. So like maybe someone that's slightly overweight, they've got a little bit of a belly, or they're just a little bit too skinny. Now I'm not saying that being overweight is good, but let's just add one thing to the mix. Perspective. Looking overweight is not necessarily unhealthy.
Like, I literally know so many people that would be called unhealthy due to how they look, but would obliterate most people in sport and cardio. Like this guy. The biggest eye-opener for me was boxing. When you see someone that's quote-unquote fit looking and they gas out after one round.
Unhealthy is when your weight, your decisions in life, your food decisions, your exercise decisions are literally damaging your mind, body and soul. But guess what? A six-pack doesn't immediately eliminate this and then deem you as healthy. If you are slightly overweight, if your blood work is fine, you don't have any weight-related mobility issues, you don't have any weight-related illnesses, and you're happy in your mind with exactly how you look, then do me this favor. Fuck society. But this bit, you have to be really honest with yourself. If you are really, really happy, like there are some people who I've seen that they're fine with how they look. They don't want the six pack. They don't want the big shoulders. They don't want the big chest. They are literally 100% deep down in their heart, happy with how they look. If that is you, then kudos. You've found a place of clarity and serenity where you can just live your life. But if you're not happy and you do want to change, let your transformation mean more to you than conforming to society and what they think you should look like. And on that note, I'm out. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. I'll catch you on the next one. That's a real one in your reflection without a follow.